Officer Kroekel, the deaf-mute lockpicking brothers from Egg Harbor City. I came across Charles Kroekel while I was doing some more serious research into the decline in public knowledge of physical security. Between 1870 and 1900, there's this amazing rise in ignorance of how locks work and how we attack them. Fantastic article about Charles Kroekel, and in it, what I was obsessed with was how it described him breaking into things. In reality, he was describing things that couldn't happen anymore. They got back to his Victorian ideas, but it also told me a little bit about the penal system in New Jersey, and it gave me a figure that I could track back and know that I would find more information. So, I continued to look for Charles Kroekel. I found another article from when he was 13 years old. He's already made it to the paper. Picking locks, and there's even more information on the penal system, and I was really excited to be getting all this great data, and then there was a line that completely threw me. The 3 years of his life, at the age of 13, he had been in jail. And this very much humanized it for me. It took me completely out of my research. So I started trying to find out more about Charles Kroekel. I began to find some descriptions of him. Some illustrations of when he was sitting before a grand jury. They described him as slight and blonde with nimble fingers and a cat-like manner. And he was a joker, too. He was a joker. At this trial, he made ovations to one of the jurors with a piece of paper to loan him 10 cents. And this is when he was 13. He also had all sorts of fantastic pranks when he was in county prison. When he was in county prison, he wouldn't try to escape because he liked it there and he liked all the people. He used to put buckets of water over the partition between the male prisoners and the female prisoners, and when he heard one of the ladies walking by, he pushed a bucket of water, which all the male prisoners thought was hilarious. Unfortunately, all of this mirth and pranking was in the midst of a really dire situation. At the age of 13, he was off to federal prison because he was escaping from everywhere else. And they just needed him in a cell and watched, otherwise he would get out of everywhere. He was assigned to hard labor. And they couldn't find any use for him because he was too small, so they finally just locked him in a cell by himself, not allowed to do anything. But he didn't stay in the cell. He wandered around. He had this piece of slate that had been given to him when he was first incarcerated. He would slip out of his cell and wander around and write questions to the older inmates to communicate about the world and find out about what the world was like. So, a couple of stats on him. By the age of 20, between 10 and 20, he had 100 charges of burglary, had appeared before 30 individual courts, had been incarcerated in every manner of incarceration in New Jersey and escaped dozens of times. He spent 3/4 of his adolescence behind jail. Enter Liz Hardy. She's a fantastic librarian out of the Boston area. I became obsessed with this, and it started interjecting itself into my talks about my main field of research. And she approached me after one of my talks and said, I want to know more about these boys. I was like, me too. So she found this. Deaf-mute burglar brothers. He had a brother, Oscar Kroekel, who was also a lockpicker and a crook, and he would break into places and just like hang out there. Oscar was 10 years old the first time he went before the court. He was actually a little bit younger than Charles when he first started getting into very serious trouble. But both of them, throughout their history, throughout all these articles I found, are described as these wonderful boys who would tell people where they found, you know, where to find the things they stole. Oscar watched a movie where a burglar broke into the second floor of a building, and he immediately, in broad daylight, walked out of the movie theater and went and did it in the building across the street just to see if he could do it. And they just hung out and waited for the police. They wanted to explore. I've been trying to find artifacts of their lives, anything that I can get my hands on. I know a lot more about them than 5 minutes could contain, but I want to know even more than that. So, this is the only photo I have of Oscar Kroekel. And when I saw the grave, it killed me. It broke my heart to suddenly realize that these people, who were born in the 1800s, were dead. And Charles. They became very real to me as I learned a lot more about them. And I was, just before this, I was trying to find some new piece of information, something fun that I could do for tonight. So I started digging back through my resources, and I found Albert Kroekel, their deaf-mute, lock-picking little brother. Is good lock bros. Join me in my research. Help me find out more about these people. Thank you very much.